today I'm going to show you what your brand new K-Pro is going to look like when you get it in the box from us. I'm going to show you how to connect it, register it, and upload the base map. So let's get into it. Brand new K-Pro. This is what it's going to look like. Brand new box from Hondata. It's going to be a sticker, warning sticker here, which is going to be sealed. You're going to have to open that. So once you open the box, ECU, HA Motorsport sticker. We work closely with HA to make sure that we provide you with the best quality ECU. These come with a 1-year warranty from HA Motorsports. Contact us if you bought it from us and we'll go ahead and help you go through the process and help it get navigated. So got stickers. Actually, I have 2 stickers in the box. Man, I love these guys. As you can tell, K-Pro case has been cleaned. It is not this raggedy OEM case that you all have in your cars. This is very nice. I don't know if you can see the detail on it. This particularly is a K-Swap ECU, so this is the one where you would have to rewire the VSS onto the K-Pro analog board here, which will be these pins. It's a really, really quick and easy thing to do, and in the settings, it's 1, 2, 3. I'll actually show you how to do that and actually show you how to calibrate it if it is wrong. So yeah, off-road use only. You know how the game goes. Don't drive this shit outside on the street. Brand new USB cable, has the ferrite beads on it. Not the Amazon special stuff. Got 2 analog connectors. You can use one for the digital or analog side. Hondata stickers, yeah. That's what everybody wants. Got 2 of them for you. To download your software, www.hondata.com/software. Link is here. You can also Google it, but it also comes on this nice little paper that's in the box. And what we have here is an installation guide, step-by-step installation guide that tells us a lot of information that sounds pretty complicated. I'm not even gonna lie. All right, make sure the ground on the head is pretty good. They pretty much tell you to move the ground from the valve cover to a stud. Install the K-Manager. Install the K-Manager, drivers. Installing USB drivers, Windows Vista. I don't think anybody uses that anymore. Installing the ECU in the vehicle. Yeah, there's a couple of instructions in here. I particularly didn't find this too helpful, but what I'll do is in this video, I'll show you like the whole 9. If you're using like Windows 10, Windows 11, not something that's outdated, I'll show you exactly step-by-step and how to set it up. So let's go ahead and pop the ECU in the car and I'll show you how to register it and then how to load the base map. All right, so we have the K-Pro. So this has the extra plug here. We're not gonna use it. So assuming that you have your RSX engine harness, not the Chinese or eBay one, please don't buy that. And then you have your nice harness here. I was fortunate to buy a hybrid conversion harness. It's pretty nice. So they give you the extra plug. This extra plug goes into the ECU. And then these 2 come off of the RSX engine harness. I'll show you how these pop in. And then this goes on the very, very end.
Okay.
So now that that's plugged in, I'm gonna go ahead and open the cable. Remember to open the cable. Don't use whatever you use. This particular cable. I'm telling you, get the best results. All right. Let's go ahead and take off these tie wraps. Alright, so now we have this end of the cable. It's kind of square, it's kind of not. So if you look here, the top part of it is more triangle shaped, and just like this top part of it here is more triangle shaped. So it's gonna go and do this. Perfect. Alright, so now we're gonna plug this into the laptop. Oh, right way up. So the filled slots on the back go on the bottom. You see how these are, it's kind of hard to see, but they're more hollow. You just pop right into your USB port. And then usually the computer will make a noise if your laptop has your sound up. Right. Right, all right, all right. See how this goes. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and key on. See, the light turned green and then the fuel pump turned on. So now we're gonna go back to our screen here. So now that we have our K-Pro open, you're gonna go ahead and click on K-Pro. Now we're gonna register the owner. So you click update / register K-Pro, and it's gonna ask you for your name, your email. I highly suggest that you fill this out correctly in case anyone steals your shit. VIN, I'm just gonna go ahead and put all zeros. Definitely put your VIN, put your phone number in. Almost forgot my phone number. Go next. So now it's gonna ask for your registration agreement within the USA under the Clean Air Act and EPA rules and regulations. This may be only used on sanctioned competition vehicles, which are never driven on public streets, roads, or highways. So if this is a USA street car, you can't use this. If this is a legit race car, you put in your racing company, the organization that sponsors your license. And then you're gonna go ahead and enter your license number. And then click next. So you do need to be connected to your Wi-Fi. So once you connect to your Wi-Fi, go ahead and click register. And then K-Pro successfully registered with Hyundai. Awesome, so then we can X out of this. And now we're gonna go ahead and go to File, New. And depending on what setup that you have. So you can usually start with a PRB ECU. I know it's a PND, but you can start with a PRB base calibration. There's nothing wrong with that. If your tuner sent you a file, then you can go ahead and just go to File, Open, and then we can open it. Or if you want to load one of the base calibrations here, like 05K20Z with cold air, dyno tuned. Or if you just want to load the stock RSX file with 410cc injectors, which isn't totally stock, so it would be 310cc's if you're running 310cc's. We're going to click OK. It's going to load the map. And then you're going to go ahead and click on this up arrow here. Upload changes to the ECU. Upload the changes. Key will cycle. Awesome. So now if you press the yellow triangle to start data logging, it'll give you error codes
For me, there's error codes. I can guarantee there's map sensor and TPS. So intake air temp isn't hooked up. Idle air control isn't hooked up. VTEC oil pressure switch isn't hooked up. And multiplexer isn't hooked up. So for VTEC oil pressure and multiplexer and idle air control valve, we can go ahead and fix, since this car doesn't have an idle air control valve. It's not going to use VTEC oil pressure. And this car doesn't have a multiplexer. It's a swap car. So we're going to go ahead and go to parameters. And it opened up here in the bottom left corner. So you know, first things first, we're going to go to multiplexer / digital output. And under multiplexer, we're going to click on disabled. Now we're going to go to miscellaneous. I highly suggest leaving these enabled. Very important. Secondary O2, ELD, purge system. Here under speed sensor is where we would change for the speed sensor output. So countershaft would be if you're using an 0506 transmission and it uses a different sensor. All you have to do is just click here and then it'll do the conversion for you. On this ECU, like I was telling you, it is a swap ECU. You would have to select alternate speed input. And usually you can start with this 10-8000 number. But sometimes you do have to manually go ahead and calibrate the number. And usually what I do is I'll go down in 100 increments. So like say we're at 10-800. So this would be like 7-800. So that's 200 pulses lower than what it was before. And if it's not making much of a change, then I would just 9000 and then re-upload and test again. So now we're going to go ahead and go to idle. We're going to disable idle valve. And then we're going to re-upload this. And then we're going to go ahead and clear DTCs. And now we have one error code: intake air temp high sensor. The sensor is not plugged in on this particular car, and VTEC oil pressure. So I didn't turn off oil pressure yet. So we're going to go to VTEC and uncheck VTEC oil pressure switch. Re-upload that. And now we're going to go ahead and clear these codes. Go to off online, clear DTCs. And now we only get the intake code. Like I said, the intake isn't plugged in. Intake air temp isn't plugged in, so it's not going to read. And that's pretty much it. If you bought this from us, if you buy this K-Pro from us, send in your car specs as far as injectors, map sensor, and what the setup is, and we'll send a base map. It might work, it might not. Not every setup is identical, but I'll go ahead and just send you this for free. Try it out. If it works, if it doesn't, great. But you have a base to start off and start adjusting for your tuner, or if you're the one actually tuning the car. And if you're the one tuning it, at a later date, I'm gonna have how-to courses on how to exactly tune your K-Pro car, tune VTC, fueling, and timing. So for right now, that should be it to get you started with your K-Pro and get you driving on the road.
All right, so I just showed you how to set up your K-Pro, put it in the car, make sure it works, load one of the factory files. Like I mentioned earlier, if you buy the K-Pro from us, just put in your engine specs when you're ordering, and we'll send you a base map to what you have, and it should be pretty good to get you running and driving and at least diagnosing the car to get it to the tuner. If you're tuning it, then go ahead and tune it, and that should be a pretty good like starting point for you. This is your K-Pro. If you want to purchase one, there's the link down below. Same thing applies to you. Give us your specs. I'll give you a base map. It's pretty simple. And look out in the future for training videos on how to tune on Hyundai K-Pro. And you know, I'll go ahead and show you how to set up fueling, why you want what fueling for what, and even the logic in why you want to have that fueling versus another AFR, right? And ignition timing, I'm sure you're all curious about, like, oh my god, ignition timing brake stuff and this and that and too much and too little and, you know, whatever nonsense on the internet. And yeah, half of it's true, half of it's not true. You also just have to mess around and find out. If you don't mess around and find out, then you'll never know. Best way to figure that out is to honestly use a loaded dyno, and you can legit just press up and keep going up in timing until the dyno tells you, like, hey, I'm not producing any more torque. And you can use that as a base with your knock sensor to figure out that, hey, I can't make any more power here. And there's also a trick to calibrating the knock sensor. Once you put exhaust and headers and everything else on the car, then it starts making a little bit more noise, a little bit more noise. So you have to desensitize the sensor a little bit to fall within where you need it now. And there's like a whole science, and there's a way to do it. And most importantly, and by far my favorite part about tuning, or even engines, tuning and engines, is reading the spark plugs and verifying what's going on inside of your engine and why it's an optimal running engine versus why it's not an optimally running, why it's an optimally running engine versus why it's not an optimally running engine. So yeah, I'll catch you guys on the next time. Subscribe, follow, show love, buy stuff, you know, whatever. If you have questions, ask the questions, go for it.